Hi, my name is Connor McClure. I'm a regional fisheries biologist with the Idaho Department of Fish and Game in the Magic Valley, and we just moved a 7-foot sturgeon from a canal where it was trapped just below Milner Dam to Lake Walcott.
So this all started when we got a phone call from a local angler, Dale Kent, who had shown up at Milner to try and catch a few rainbows out of the canal, and there weren't any rainbows there, but there was a giant 7-foot sturgeon swimming around. And so it's really no surprise when thinking about things that when there's a 7-foot sturgeon trapped in a small body of water that it draws attention, as you can see by the onlookers here in this video. And as part of this process, we also worked with the Northside Canal Company, who gave us access to their canal to get in, trap the fish, and transport it. Here we are at the release location at Lake Walcott, and sturgeon, similar to sharks, are cartilaginous fishes, meaning their skeletal system is made primarily of cartilage, not bones, such as trout and bass and other fishes. And so what we have here is a sling that we're using to transport the fish, and distributes the weight of the sturgeon along the sling and better protects its internal organs from damage during transfer. So prior to releasing this fish in a reservoir, we collected some biological data here. We pit tagged the fish, which gives the sturgeon an individual identification number so we can track it at a later point in time. We took a genetic sample. We also took a total length measurement and a few girth measurements. After collecting the biological data, it was then time to go ahead and release the fish into the water. And while we don't typically make such efforts for individual bass and trout, things of that nature, with the sturgeon that's long-lived, we do make an effort. And fish like this, there's opportunity to be able to target this fish for decades to come.